तू सर्वबल है प्रभु। उठती लहरों में डूबती नैया में, उठती लहरों में डूबती नैया में, तू ही है मेरा कप्तान, संग मेरे इस दर में आ, तू ही है मेरा कप्तान, संग मेरे इस दर में
thank Pastor Chaitanya introducing me, and also I thank all the pastors team that are working in Capstone AG in Hyderabad. I thank God for the opportunity God has given me, a privilege to speak to you on today, and also I thank all the people, those are online, to participate in this worship service. I would like to share about me for a bit of my life. I was born in a remote village in Guntur district, and I studied in the same village up to 8th standard, and I studied my English under Telugu Pandit, and the Telugu Pandit was a Brahmin, and he doesn't like the British people, and he doesn't like the Christians, and he doesn't like Christian people in the school also. So under him I learned my English. I learned my English under him. So my English is a Telugu English. There are many languages in the world. They speak their own language, English. Chinese speak their Chinese English, and this Chinese English different from the British English, and British English different from the American English. American English is different from Australian English. In the same way, in our country also, there are different languages, and we have different languages. We speak our English with the accent of our own language. In the same way, I speak with the accent of Telugu, the English. So I would like to bear with me throughout this service to listen my Telugu English. I would like to share with you today about the vision. I would like to read the scripture portion from Book of Acts, 26th chapter, beginning from 19th and 20th verses. Book of Acts, 26th chapter, beginning from 19th verse and 20th verse. Therefore, King Agrippa, I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision, but declared first to those in Damascus and in Jerusalem and throughout all the region of Judea and then to Gentiles that they should repent, turn to God and do works befitting repentance. This is the statement Paul was speaking in the court of Caesarea. And in the Agrippa was the king in that region, and also Festus was the representative or procure of the Roman Empire in that region, Caesarea. So Paul was standing before them and giving his testimony. In that testimony, he mentioned this, right, addressing the King Agrippa. I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision that declared first to those in Damascus and in Jerusalem and throughout all the region of Judea and then to the Gentiles that they should repent and turn to God and do works befitting repentance. Dear friends, I would like to share with you about the vision. And Paul addressing the audience of Jewish people and the high priest, and also he was in front of Festus and Agrippa. Before their presence, he was telling that he was not disobedient to the vision that God has given to him on the road of Damascus. Dear friends, everybody will have a vision of their own lives. But now I would like to share with you what is the meaning of vision. Oxford Dictionary gives the definition of vision: ability to see beyond the nature. The ability to see beyond the nature. The second, inspired idealistic ideas of the future. This is the description given of the vision in the Oxford Dictionary. In another dictionary, it was defined as this. It was defined, the vision, as the experience of seeing someone and something in a dream or trance or supernatural apparition. So these are the secular meaning of the vision, according to the Oxford Dictionary, and also another dictionary, they describe the vision like this. But I would like to share with you the biblical realm and spiritual realm of the vision. Vision is a burden and purpose that God put in our hearts. Ezekiel has a vision given to him. He has a real burden, and God has given him a vision of the people of Israel. And second thing, when we have deep and strong sense of the presence of God in prayer, God gives the vision. Isaiah is one of the men who has a strong and deep sense of presence of God in prayer, and also Daniel. These both were the examples of this meaning. The third, vision may be given in a dream. Like Joseph had a dream, even Daniel has many dreams about the future of the world. Fourth one, suddenly, unexpectedly, God gives the vision. Suddenly, unexpectedly, God gives the vision. Like Moses. Moses never expected in his life that God will appear to him, but God appeared in the wilderness of Sin, and God spoke to him about his purpose in his life. In the same way, Paul never expected the appearance of Jesus Christ while he was going to Damascus to persecute the Christians. Jesus appeared to him suddenly and unexpectedly and gave the vision of his ministry. So we also compare, so the visions are, all the visions are not from God. All the dreams are not from God. All the prophecies are not from God. I will repeat again. All the visions are not from God. All the dreams are not from God. All the prophecies are not from God. So we always to compare or tally with the scriptures. Paul was telling about this one in 2 Timothy 3rd chapter and 16th verse. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. I will repeat the scripture. All scripture is given by inspiration of God, is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, and for instruction in righteousness. So we always have to compare and tally with the scriptures when you have a vision, or when you have a dream, or when you have a prophecy from other people or prophecy from direct from God. You need to always compare and tally with the scriptures if those visions are with those promises or with those dreams are not according to the scripture, you have to reject them. There is a possibility to interpret the scripture out of context. When you do that, you end up with a wrong doctrine and false teaching. I would like to repeat again. There is a possibility to interpret scripture out of context. When you do that, you end up with a wrong doctrine and a false teaching. Devil quoted scripture out of the context in the temptation of Jesus, saying, if you are a son of God, throw yourself down from this pinnacle. For it was written, he shall give the angels charge over, and in their hands they shall bear you up. Let dash your foot against stone. Right interpretation of the scripture is that somebody wants to push you down from mountain or high place to kill you, then God charge the angels to guard you. That is the right interpretation. But devil, they have quoted the scripture out of the context and tempted Jesus Christ. But Jesus, quoting the scripture from the same Bible, and he defeated the devil's tactics. So we need to be very careful when you are interpreting the scripture. If you are interpreting the scripture out of the context, it will become a wrong doctrine and a false teaching. There are many other scriptures people interpret out of context with selfish motives. So you should be very careful and watch a people on such interpretations. God gives vision to one man only. God gives vision to one man only. God gives vision to one man only. God gave vision of the land and the nation to Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, and 12 tribes of Israel are part of the vision. They all are participated and supported to fulfill the vision of their forefather Abraham. Now we have a land of Israel and the nation of Israel. Dear friends, God gives the vision to one man only, and other people has to cooperate and participate and support that vision. Now we have a capstone AG. God gave vision to the pastor of this assembly. After God enabled the pastor to begin and pioneer the capstone assembly, God brought you all into this fellowship to fulfill the vision which God gave to the pastor. You all are participating and fulfilling the vision by joining your hearts and hands with pastor. Then together you are fulfilling the purpose of God through the Capstone AG Church. God gave Moses the vision of liberating the people of Israel from Egypt slavery. Aaron, Miriam, and Joshua participated and supported the vision that God gave to Moses. Later, 70 were selected to be supportive in the vision of Moses. But those who rebelled the vision of God, they were thrown out, but the vision liberation was continued. All the members of the Capstone, I urge you in the name of Jesus, don't be deceived by the tactics of the devil. Be one mind and one purpose to fulfill the vision of the Capstone. Lastly, I would like to share with you, vision gives faith and boldness. First, vision gives faith and boldness. If you take the life of Abraham comes from an idol worship family, an idol worship country, but God told him leave his own country, own people, and he left the country according to the call of God, and he had a faith in God. Not only that, he has a boldness to step out of his own country and own people and own relationship to go to the place where God asked him to go. So the vision of the purpose of God to Abraham gave him faith and boldness. The second, the vision gives hope of the future. Vision gives the hope of the future. Abraham saw the future. He saw in distant in which God is going to use him to build a nation for himself. So the vision gives hope of the future. It doesn't speak only the present, but it helps us to hope of the future. Thirdly, vision helps us to look to God in the midst of opposition and obstacles. Vision helps us to look to God in the midst of opposition and obstacle. Dear friends, when God has given vision to us, or when God has a purpose in our life that is revealed to you or to me, to anyone, then that we face many problems in our lives. We face many obstacles to fulfill that vision or the dream or the prophecy that was given to us by God. But you need to stand firm on the faith to see the fulfillment of that vision. For example, Joseph had a dream, but he faced many obstacles in his life. He faced his own brothers, mocked at him, persecuted him, stoned him, and put him in a deep well, and they sold him as a slave to the merchants, and he was brought by Potiphar in Egypt as a slave. He was as a slave working in the house of the Potiphar, but he was blamed, which he was not done, and he was put into prison. All these activities, all these incidents in our life, in his life, may discourage him, but he looked to God, and he looked the fulfillment of the vision with patience, and God brought him to fulfillment of the dream in the end of his life. Dear friends, in the same way, if you have a vision from God, if you have a promise from God, if you have a prophecy from God, and if you have a dream from God, it will come to fulfillment if you patiently wait with all the opposition and with all the obstacles in your life. The fourth one, God's vision will have ultimate victory. God's vision will have ultimate victory. You may face that you are defeated, the present situation. You may be thinking that you may be discouraged for the present situation. You may be dismayed in our present situation. But the God's vision will come into fulfillment in its own time. But the vision that God has given will have ultimate victory. You see, life of Jesus Christ, before he was resurrected, he was crucified, he was beaten, he was crowned with the thorns of crown, and he was nailed to the cross, and he was pierced to his side, and he was nailed his hands and legs. Dear friends, he has undergone a lot of pain and agony to sacrifice his life for the sins of the world, but the ultimate is the victory he won through the resurrection. Dear friends, there is a resurrection for your life. There is a revival for your life. There is a revival for your vision. There is a revival for your dream. There is a revival for the promise God has made to you. So God's vision will have ultimate victory. Fifth one, visionary may die, but God gives the vision to continue to fulfill the purpose of the vision. I will repeat the fifth one. Visionary may die, or visionary may out of that place, but God given vision continue to fulfill the purpose of God. I would like to share with you my personal life story. God told me to go to Ballari in 1976. We went in July 1976. I took 3 days fasting and prayer and asking God to show me or to tell me what was the purpose for bringing me to Ballari. I was doing fasting and prayer for 3 days. At the end of the third day, I stopped fasting and I came out of my room and I was about to take tea somewhere, another place. I was coming back after I took tea. God spoke to me clearly with audible voice in my ear. As I was walking back to my room, God spoke to me with audible voice saying, read Acts 18th chapter 9th and 10th verses. Read Acts 18th chapter 9th and 10th verses. I read book of Acts many times, but I couldn't remember at the time what was there in those verses. I went to the room and opened the Bible, book of Acts and 18th chapter, 9 and 10 verses I read. When I was reading those two verses, my whole body was electrified and all the air on my body stood up and the Holy Spirit covered over me when I was reading that scripture, Acts 18, 9 and 10. The scripture says, be not be silent. Preach the gospel. I have many people in this city. That is the promise God gave to me. That is the prophecy God spoke over me during my ministry in Ballari. That was the God, the vision, the God, God gave the vision of Ballari to see many people come to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. I was pastor there and pioneered 12 years. By the 12 years, we have a main church of 500 people. All 500 people out of 80% of the 500 are from idol worship families. Only maybe 20 or 15% from nominal Christians. At the same time, we established churches in Thornagal and in Avambai and Mooka and Bahagari. There are four places we pioneered other branch churches. But God spoke to me in 1987, you have to move from this place. Then I argued with God, Lord, you promised me that there are many people in this city. Now you are asking me to leave this city. Then God told me, it is not your vision. It is not your purpose. It is my vision, my purpose. I will do it even though you are not in that place. According to the God's guidance and the leading of the Holy Spirit, I left the Ballari in 1988 in July and came to Hyderabad to take up the Assemblies of God work in Andhra Pradesh. Dear friends, recently I visited Ballari. And the people in Ballari were telling me, through the church that was established in Ballari, through those churches now, they have 100 churches. So the God fulfills the vision if the visionary was not there, or if the visionary dies, God continues to fulfill the vision God has given to us. So dear friends, never be discouraged. Whatever the situation, whatever the opposition, or whatever the obstacles that come across to do the will, to do the vision of God in our lives. So I would like to say, Abraham did not see all what God had promised him while he was on earth. Even now, that vision is continuing to fulfill God's purpose. Lastly, I will encourage you, have a God-given vision. Have a God-given dream. Have a God-given prophecy. He enables to fulfill the vision or the dream or prophecy. Lastly, vision without mission is an empty dream. Mission without vision is a shallow dream. God may bless you. Amen. Father God, we thank you for your grace you have extended to each one of us, O Father. I thank you for all the people, those who listen, those who participated in this worship service and online, O Father. Bless all the people, O Father. Particularly, I pray for the members of Capstone AG Hyderabad. Bless them, O Father. Strengthen their faith in you, O Father. Thank you for the vision you have given to Pastor Chaitanya. Lord, I thank you for all the people whom you brought into this fellowship. May cooperate and may be supportive, may be participate in the vision that God has given to him, O Father, O God. Lord, the devil has many tactics to disturb and distort the purpose for which the Capstone Church was established, O Father. I ask your Holy Spirit may minister to the members of this family in this fellowship. Give them oneness of mind and oneness of spirit and oneness of purpose in their lives so that they may be united to support and participate the vision that has given to this church, O Father, O God. I thank you for all these years that you blessed this congregation and the fellowship to bless in many ways, in many places, O Father, O God. I thank you for the activities and the programs that the Capstone AG started to glorify you through those programs and those activities. Lord, bless those activities and also bless those things, O Father, whatever you have put in their hearts, O Father. Lord, thank you for all the pastoral team that are working with him, O Father. Bless them, O Father. Help them to unite with the vision that has given to this church, O Father. Bless their families. Bless their children, O Father. Lord, I pray for all the people, those who are working in the office, and also people, those who are working on this on this team, O Father, to create this kind of technology, O Father. I pray for all the people, those who are working on this technology, O Father. Bless them, O Father. Bless their families, O God, so that they may bring glory to you by the talent you have given to them, O Father. Bless them. I also ask your blessing upon Pastor Chaitanya and Janet and their children, O Father, O God. I commit them into your mighty hand. Lord, I lay their family upon your altar as a living sacrifice, O Father. Accept them as a burnt offering for your service. Whatever the purpose, Lord, you have for this family and for this capstone age, O Father, let this purpose may be fulfilled in the days to come, O Father. Whatever the devil brings across to stop the vision and the purpose, O Father, all those tactics may be destroyed in the name of Jesus, O Father. Let your name be glorified. Let your vision may be continued. Let your prophecy may be fulfilled. Let your dream may come into fulfillment, O Father, O God, in the lives of this family and also with your capstone age, O Father. Lord, I thank you for the people, those who are praying for this capstone church, O Father. Bless them, O Father. And also, I thank for the people, those who are contributing to develop and to support the mission's work through this capstone age, O Father. Lord, bless them, O Father. Reward them from heaven, O Father. Lord, I pray for their families, for their children, O Father. Oh, Lord, I pray everyone in that family may know you as their personal Savior and have an assurance of the forgiveness of sins in their lives, O Father. And also, I pray for all the missionaries that are being supported by Capstone AG, not only in India and in abroad, O Father, O God. I pray, Lord, for all the missionaries may have a passion for the souls to reach in their own areas, O Father. Give them the vision. Give them the dream. Give them the prophecy, O Father. O God, Lord, I pray, O Father, bless them, O Father, as we are in the end days of, Lord, I pray the church may be prepared to meet to you, O Father. Forgive all our sins and shortcomings in our lives, O Father. Cleanse with your precious blood, O Father, our hearts, our minds. Give us a fresh anointing upon our lives. Give the fresh anointing of this AG, Capstone AG. Give a fresh anointing on the pastoral team and also the main senior pastor, Pastor Chaitanya and Janet, O Father. Lord, bless them, O Father. Strengthen their faith. Give them the hope, O Father, that you will fulfill whatever the purpose you have called them. Lord, we thank you once again. We commit this Capstone AG and the pastoral team and the senior and lead pastor Chaitanya and Janet into your mighty hand. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
बल है प्रभु, तू मेरा बल है प्रभु,
तू मेरा बल है प्रभु,
तू सर्वबल है प्रभु। उठती लहरों में डूबती नैया में, उठती लहरों में डूबती नैया में, तू ही है मेरा कप्तान, संग मेरे इस दर में आ, तू ही है मेरा कप्तान, संग मेरे इस दर में आ। सब कुछ है तू ही प्रभु, मेरा जीवन तू ही प्रभु, मेरा प्यार भी तू ही प्रभु, खूबसूरती तू ही प्रभु, मेरा सब कुछ है तू ही प्रभु, मेरा जीवन तू ही प्रभु, मेरा प्यार भी तू ही प्रभु, खूबसूरती तू ही प्रभु, मेरा सब कुछ है तू ही प्रभु, तू मेरा बल है प्रभु, तू मेरा बल है प्रभु,
सर्वबल है प्रभु।